your pet. Good evening and welcome to a wonderful session right here at Oman Convention and Exhibition Center, because we are here at the SMEs exhibition, and this is a fabulous place to come out and check out the latest of designs and ideas that have come from the SMEs in Oman. Today, of course, as you know, our guest is Dr. Ahmed Al Ghassani. He is the CEO of Riyada. Welcome to the O Show.
Thank you very much, and I'm very pleased to join you here on this program today.
This is indeed an excellent exposure to the SMEs, and this is an annual event.
Yes.
And from your perspective, what seems to be exciting?
Well, first of all, I would like to say that this is the sixth edition of the Oman SMEs Expo. And over the past five years, we have seen increase in the quality of the institutes participating. This year we have classified the institutes into nine sections.
Oh, I see.
So each section focuses on a specific area. There are areas of industry, there are areas on foodstuff, there are areas of jewelry, design, innovation, students projects. We have 5 plus 4, that is 9 students projects. There is the engineering village, which is an educational village for kids, which shows them how to innovate, how to think differently, how to think in an engineering way. We have many products today, and one of the key observations that we can see is the improvements of the quality of the products. We have some institutes that were established last year during this exhibition.
Okay.
And today this institute celebrated its first anniversary.
Oh, really?
They had 18 products last year, if I'm not wrong, I think 8 products. Now they have more than 80 products. They have their products in 17 branches.
Mm-hmm.
And we have many other innovative areas in the exhibition. The number of applicants or registered institutes to participate in this exhibition was overwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
However, we had certain criteria.
Okay.
And we had certain cap for the number of participants in each sector.
To maintain the quality,
industry.
Maybe.
To maintain the quality and also to diversify, to give the visitors an opportunity to see different innovations, different products, different ideas. We have products ranging from IT and technology products, like the O Taxi company, which is a company that has a database of taxis in Oman, where you can pick up a taxi without having to wait on the street or without making a call. You just need to go through the application and pick up the taxi. We have new products in industrial field. Fire and safety in products. We have actually for the first time some of the very popular SME designers of clothes. Some of them, they were not used to participating in this exhibition. However, this year they have seen value in being here, and they found that this exhibition brings more popularity to them, more business, more customers.
And the exposure to the customers themselves. Dr. Ahmed, if we could just look around so our viewers also could see what the exhibition is all about. We are at Oman Convention and Exhibition Center. And one thing, Dr., I've noticed is most of the SMEs, also micro companies, they are utilizing the social media in a big way. So this is a very important interactive session for them to meet face-to-face with the customers.
Indeed, actually many of them, they started publicizing their presence here in the exhibition.
Okay.
They started informing their customers that they have special discounts in the exhibition, that they have new products that they launched here for the first time. And we have seen that the social media has played a key role in bringing many people into this exhibition. Also, as you can see in the middle here, we have this year introduced the fine arts section, because we wanted to show innovations of different types. So
okay.
We have many artists who participated here. One of them, she got all her paint something sold on the first day.
Really?
Yes, and she brought new ones today. So there is also a section which we call the young businessman or the young entrepreneur, and these are kids of age of 8 to 12 years. And
they are here too?
Yes, they are there at the far end on the left side with their products displayed there.
Yes, okay.
Yes. So we have actually involved and engaged the whole community, starting from kids, going through schools, going to graduates who have new and innovative ideas, and the business people who started 1 year ago. Some of them, they started just 2 weeks ago, 1 month or 2 months ago, and there are others who have been in the market for 20 or 25 years, or all are presenting success stories that we are very proud of.
Excellent. So if you look at the jewelry, I mean, there's a great response immediately, and these are the paintings Dr. Ahmed was talking about. It's a whole row. So there are many artists participating with us?
Yes, there are several artists, and one of them actually at the far end, she's conducting the training workshops for
kids.
Yes. They start in the evening around 7 o'clock. And yesterday they were targeting to train 6 kids, and the number went to 16. So they had to bring many chairs, tools, and the kids were very excited about learning how to do their paintings. They had samples, there were all the colors and all the materials, the canvas, and they were showing their talent in this exhibition.
Okay, so this is what is happening here at Oman Convention and Exhibition Center. Right in the middle, we have the art, and of course all the products are here. And we've got some youngsters here with cats. What could this be?
Yeah, this section is from schools. So these are school students who have developed some projects.
Okay.
And their projects and products exist in their schools, so they have moved from the ideation into creation of business, and they are doing business in the schools now.
In the school itself?
In the school itself.
Very nice.
For example, this one focuses on the green agriculture, where they use grey water, they use recycled water, and they have, you can see in the image there, they have created small plant within each school where students can enjoy the agriculture, they learn more about it, and also they take the fruits and they sell them. So that is a practice of the business. And this program has become very popular now, so it exists in several schools.
Many schools. Okay. So we'll just take a look at some of the crops they have. And they sell the crops, but do they sell the plants? Do they sell it like a nursery?
In the schools, they plant them, and then they take the benefit
the
of the fruits and the crops. But here in the exhibition, they do sell them.
Oh, they are selling.
So these are strawberries that they have planted in the schools, and now they are bringing them here as business for the students. So they sell them, and the revenue goes to the students.
Wow.
ايضا ماء اللي نجيبه من كيف عشان نزرع البحر مالحة وهذا ماء
They use the water that comes from the air conditioners, so they don't use salt water that comes from the sea. They help in protecting the environment by using and reusing the resources.
Interesting. And utilizing something.
Yeah, and actually this is a new concept that is called the circular economy, where you reuse raw materials and reuse and reuse before disposing. They don't use chemicals.
Oh, it's organic.
It's all organic.
Where is the school located?
In Suwaik.
In Suwaik. Maybe you can drive up to Suwaik. It's nice to get organic.
We have been visited by the FAO Institute of the United Nations.
Oh, Food and Agriculture Organization.
فكرة دعم وزارة التربية 50,000 ناس يستطيعوا نفس الفكرة في المدارس الخاصة. يعني دعم حل
50,000
وزارة التربية
Minister of Agriculture was very excited about the project, so he decided to fund this project so that they have them in the school. They funded the initial stage by 50,000 riyals, so that they can have it as many as possible.
Okay. And they're managing it all themselves, as I can see it now. They're watching the plants and making sure. So it's a very hands-on experience for them.
It is, yeah. And he was referring to that small insect on the screen.
Yeah.
This insect is beneficial to the plant and to the tree, and it kills the others.
Yeah.
So they keep these insects and they protect them so that. They develop their own chemicals.
Okay.
So they develop their own chemicals rather than using chemical.
Oh, so they're using garlic and chili.
Yes.
Okay. So that's the pesticide.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And so there is so much to learn.
These are also students from the schools.
Students. Okay.
These are their products.
Okay.
They have developed some oils, some soup, creams.
Which school, where are you from? Where is your school located?
North Sharqiya.
From Luban? Okay.
Yeah, the frankincense.
Water, frankincense water.
Yeah.
Oil.
Oil.
Water Luban.
Okay.
Perfume.
Okay.
Lotion.
Beautiful. See, we will learn to do it all in the school. Excellent. And what is this? Oh, it's her product, okay.
Let's have it.
And,
lipstick.
Lip gloss.
It looks different.
And what is this?
You know when the honey is created, there is wax there.
Wax.
So this is the honey wax.
Oh, fantastic. What do you do with it?
So she's just displaying it, they use it for the products that they manufacture.
What is this? I saw that.
This is the same after they have cleaned it and melted it.
Okay. Wow, this is very exciting.
Thank you.
Students from the Higher College of Technology.
Okay.
So they have developed their own projects and products as well. This section is about clothes, designs. This section is about foodstuff and other industries and technology.
Manufacturing also, I think.
Yeah. For example, if you look at that one,
the doors?
That is a very innovative idea. These doors are of PVC, new PVC.
Okay.
They create them so that they look like wood. And they take the Omani conventional design of doors and woods, and they put it into these UPVC doors and windows. And this project has been expanding over the past few years very largely. Now they have a large number of contracts with different companies to supply the material.
So we've been talking and looking at the SMA's exhibition. It's on till Friday.
Exactly. It's on until Friday evening,
ten o'clock. But what's also exciting is tomorrow we'll see the Riyada talk. That's on Thursday.
Yes.
And it's a two-day event, Thursday and Friday.
Exactly.
And what is Riyada talk about? And what is the objective?
We walk a little bit. I'll show you where it will be.
Yes.
And while walking, I'll tell you about it.
Okay.
This is one of the robots that has been made by some of the
students. Oh, really? Made by students?
Yeah. Yesterday we saw it work. This one, it's a solar panel.
Solar, so again, renewable energy and perfect for the future. Okay.
So Riyada talk actually is a new idea.
Okay.
حضورنا الكرام نرحب بكم جميعا هنا في معرض منتجات رواد الأعمال إبداعات رومانية النسخة الثالثة والتي انطلقت في 26 وستستمر.
because they are into their own businesses and they have their road routes, and you can come and check them out because it's an excellent opportunity.
لشركة صدى لتنظيم الحفلات ستقدم مجموعة من المسابقات الخاصة للأطفال والكبار.
And now we are at a different location, and this is where we're going to see.
Here where we conduct a workshop on fine arts. On this stage we have the Riyada talk that will be tomorrow and after tomorrow. Riyada talk is a new idea that we are creating here. It consists of two parts. Tomorrow will be one part that is the inspirational success stories. So we'll have five speakers. Each of them will talk about his success story. And these success stories, actually, we have opened the door for anyone to register. And we have total 73 registered
to speak.
Actually, there are two parts. So they registered for the two parts. We have selected five for the success stories and seven for the competition. The success stories is inspirational, and both days will be broadcasted live on TV, so that it's not only those who are joining us here, it's for the whole public in Oman and outside Oman can see and learn from these experiences. So this is the first day, that is tomorrow 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. After tomorrow, Friday, we'll have the second part, which is the competition. Again, it's part of Riyada Talk. That competition, we bring a group of entrepreneurs who have either new ideas or they have projects and they want to expand. So they go on to the stage, each of them presents his idea, and then we have a group of jury. And this jury panel actually are funding bodies. So they provide them with either grant or a loan, or they join them into partnership in doing the business. So we have invited many business people, we have invited the funding bodies that would give loans or would give grant. They will listen to the ideas and to the projects, and each of them will decide which project they want to support, which one they want to give a grant, which one they want to give a loan. And we have been looking at projects that would require loans of up to 200,000 Omani riyals. And there are others that are requesting for grants of 15 to 20,000 riyals each. And many of them are for the good cause of people. So tomorrow and the day after will be very active here. It will be very energetic, and we expect a lot of competition.
What time should people come here?
7 o'clock we'll start the program.
Evening.
7 o'clock in the evening,
okay.
Tomorrow and the day after.
Okay.
And we expect that